Good morning students. In previous class we discussed the observation of nucleus in six cells. Today we will discussing about the diversity in cells. Okay children, in onion peel cells we seen that nearly all cells are similar in structure and similar in shape because onion cell is a example of plant cells. In plant cells all cells are appear similar in structure and shape. There are millions of living organisms present in the nature. They have different shapes. All organisms are not same in size, same in shape, and they does not contain same number of cells. So all organisms have different shapes, different sizes, and they vary in the number of cells. Children, we will learn how to observe permanent slides of amoeba.
Amoeba, Paramecium, and Chlamydomonas. These are all the unicellular organisms.
Children, we will learn how to observe permanent slide of amoeba, paramecium, and chlamydomonas. All these organisms are single-celled organisms.
Because they contain only one cell. So they are known as unicellular organisms. Uni means Uni means single.
Amoeba, paramecium, and chlamydomonas. All these organisms contain only one cell. So these organisms are known as single cellular organisms or unicellular organisms. Uni means single. The entire life process of these organisms are occurred in a only one cell. These life process like respiration, excretion, growth, reproduction, circulation, etc. All these life process are occurred in a single cell. So children, we can observe the structure of amoeba. This is the structure of amoeba. In this amoeba, this is known as pseudopodia.
Pseudopodia. This is nucleus. This was food vacuole. Food vacuole. This is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm.
This is the structure of amoeba. Actually, amoeba is not a certain shape. It is a shapeless organism. So, this is the structure of amoeba. This part is pseudopodia. The inner part is cytoplasm. This was nucleus and this is food vacuole. This is one of the unicellular organism. It contains only one cell. All the life processes are occur only in the single cell. So, and next organism is paramecium. Next organism is paramecium. Paramecium. This is also known as slipper animalcule. Slipper animalcule. Slipper animalcule because it looks like a slipper shape. ఇది చూస్తానికి స్లిప్పర్ ఆకారంలో మన చెప్పు ఆకారంలో ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి పారామిషియం ఇస్ ఆల్సో నోన్ యాజ్ స్లిప్పర్ యానిమల్ క్యూర్. దిస్ ఈజ్ ద లుక్ చిల్డ్రన్ These diagrams are very very important. Paramecium, Chlamydomonas and amoeba. Very very important in the examination. These small egg-like structures are known as cilia. These are the locomotory organs of paramecium. Okay children, this is paramecium. These small egg-like structures are known as cilia. This is food vacuole. Food vacuole. This is cytostrome. This is a mouth of the paramecium, but it is not a real mouth. It is known as cytostrome. This is nucleus. Nucleus. In paramecium, mainly two nucleus is present. The large one is known as macronucleus. The bigger one is known as macronucleus, and the small one is known as, this is known as micronucleus. In paramecium, mainly two types of nucleus are present. The bigger one is known as macronucleus and the small one is known as micronucleus, and this is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm. This is the structure of paramecium. It is also one of the unicellular organism. The entire cell is made up of only one cell. All the life processes are occurred in a single cell. Okay children, and again another example is Chlamydomonas. क्लामिडोमोनास। क्लामिडोमोनास क्लामिडोमोनास इट इज वन ऑफ द ऑटोट्रॉफिक ऑर्गेनिज्म। इट इज दिस इज द शेप ऑफ क्लामिडोमोनास। This is flagella. This is the structure of Chlamydomonas. Amoeba, Paramecium and Chlamydomonas. These three diagrams are very very important. These three are the examples of unicellular organisms. All these organisms contain only one cell. So they are known as single cellular organisms or unicellular organisms. Okay children. So all are practice these diagrams very well because they are very very important. The today's homework is read the lesson and activities observation of nucleus in sick cells, observation of nucleus in onion peel cells and observation of cells and how to prepare slide. These are the questions given for the homework. Okay, thank you.